It is.
Santa Fe Institute for Spirituality presents St. Augustine, a man for today. From the Listen, Learn, and Love series. St. Augustine on God. Presented by Christian brother Brian Dybowski.
To give himself to wisdom. This switch from dominating to donating was his first step. But how could he advance toward wisdom, which leads to God? His own efforts utterly failed. So he began to accept more and more of God's free gifts. Later on, he developed in detail what these gifts or graces are, and how they enable us to advance toward God. As Augustine says in Confessions, God guided and impelled him onward. These gifts of guidance and impulsion along his inner path animated his observable outer path. Internal surrender to wisdom energized his natural love for everyone. He expressed this internal love by external discussions to intensify and extend his friendships. Discussion is give and take, listening to hear accurately before responding. This exchange grew into prayer, surely the most important step on his path. As Augustine prayed, he remembered God's gifts so generously given. When he thanked God, he received new gifts. Among these blessings, sacred scripture surpassed all the rest. Augustine gradually changed his mind from rejecting to accepting scripture. Then he looked past superficial rhetoric to profound meaning. Once he realized that the Bible is God's word, Augustine saw how swiftly it enabled him to surge toward God. Scripture was the verbal path to eternal wisdom. Ultimately, the Bible clarifies everything in Christ. Jesus is God incarnate, or revelation in the flesh. Gospels expressed Christ partially, through a glass darkly. But so much of Jesus shines through that scripture that it is the most direct path to God. By the Bible, Christ leads us to join his people, the church. After Cicero pointed Augustine to eternal wisdom, he dialogued with philosophical wisdom. This process pointed him to Scripture, which pointed him to Jesus, who pointed him to his community, the church. Several contesting groups claimed to be the church. Augustine struggled until he discerned his ultimate path, the Catholic Church. You could say that Augustine discussed his way into the Catholic Church. As his writings show, he considered many reasons pro and con before finalizing his decision.